solving kinematics problems using differentiation and integration. Velocity is the rate of change of displacement, and acceleration is the rate of change of velocity. As differentiation and integration are inverse processes, we can find the velocity and displacement if we know the acceleration. If we integrate acceleration, we get an expression for velocity. If we are integrating acceleration, we will get an expression for velocity. In the same way, if we integrate velocity, we get distance or displacement. In short, we can tell, from if we have displacement, if we differentiate, we get velocity. If we differentiate velocity, we get acceleration. In the same way, when we integrate acceleration, we get velocity. When we integrate velocity, we get displacement. This is a thing which you need to remember. First question, a particle P travels in a straight line from A to D, passing through the points B and C. For the section AB, the velocity of the particle is 0.5t minus 0.01t square meter per second, where t seconds is the time after leaving A. First part, given that the acceleration of P at B is 0.1 meter per second square, find the time taken for P to travel from A to B. The acceleration of P from B to C is constant and it's equal to 0.1 meter per second square. Second part, given that P reaches C with speed 14 meter per second, find the time taken for P to travel from B to C. P travels with constant deceleration 0.3 meter per second square from C to D. Given that the distance CD is 300 meters, find the speed with which P reaches D, the distance AD. Now in our question, AB is given as V equal to 0.5T minus 0.01T square, and the acceleration is given in this case as 0.1 meter per second square. And we know A equal to acceleration is dv over dt. That is, when we differentiate this, this is 0.5 minus 0.01 into 2t. That will be equal to, our acceleration is nothing but 0.1. Instead of it, we can replace it, minus 0.02t. So when we simplify, t will be equal to 20 seconds. Now in the second part of the question, at B, V will be equal to 0.5t minus 0.01t square. At B, t equal to 20 seconds. That was, we have calculated over here, 20 seconds. So our V will be equal to 0.5 into 20 minus 0.01 into 20 square. That will be equal to 6 meters per second. Therefore, velocity at B equal to 6 meters per second. For BC, in our question, it is given that A equal to 0.1 meter per second square and V equal to 1 meter per second and U equal to 6 meter per second. So using V equal to U plus AT, we get it as 14 equal to 6 plus 0.1 into T, which simplifies to T will be equal to 80 seconds. Now the third part, for CD, it's given A equal to minus 0.3 meter per second square, S equal to 300 meters, and U equal to 14 meter per second. So now using the formula V square equal to U square plus 2AS, V square will be equal to 14 square minus 2 into minus 0.3 into 300. This will be equal to 16. So V squared equal to 16, V will be equal to 4 meter per second. Now for AB, we have V equal to 0.5t minus 0.01t squared. As the velocity equal to differentiation of the displacement. And ds over dt, instead of V, we are replacing it as ds over dt will be equal to 0.5t minus 0.01t squared. Now, shift this dt to the other side so that we can integrate it. 0.5t minus 0.01t squared into dt. Now integrating both the sides, when we integrate it, we get this as s will be equal to 0.5 into t square over 2 minus 0.01 into t cube over 3 and a plus c. When time equal to 0, then the distance traveled will also be 0. So which implies when we substitute in all this, we get c equal to 0. Therefore, our equation for s will become 0.25 t square minus 0.00333 t cube. From part 1, time taken by P to travel from A to B is 20 seconds. Therefore, distance AB equal to 0.25 into 20 square minus 0.00333 into 20 cube. So when we simplify this, we get our answer as 73.33 meters. Now for BC. Using the formula V square equal to U square plus 2AS, 14 square will be equal to 6 square plus 2 into 0.1 into S. So 0.2S will be equal to 160, which implies S will be equal to 800 meters. It's given in the question, given distance CD equal to 300 meters. Therefore, total distance AD will be equal to 73.33 plus 800 plus 300. So all this when we add it, it is 1173.34 meters. The second question, a vehicle is moving in a straight line. The velocity V meter per second at time t seconds after the vehicle starts is given by V equal to A into 1 minus 0.05 t square for 0 less than or equal to t less than or equal to 15. V equal to B over t square for t greater than or equal to 15, where A and B are constants. The distance traveled by the vehicle between t equal to 0 and t equal to 15 is 225 meters. First part, find the value of A and show that B equal to 3375. Second, find an expression in terms of t for the total distance traveled by the vehicle when t is greater than or equal to 15. Third part, find the speed of the vehicle when it has traveled a total distance of 315 meters. The second part, let S1 be the distance traveled between t equal to 0 and t equal to 15. Given V equal to A into T minus 0.05 T squared for 0 less than or equal to T less than or equal to 15. We know that V equal to dS over dt. That is, instead of this V, we can replace it as dS over dt will be equal to A into T minus 0.05 T squared. Now we can guess S1 we have calculated taken as a distance travel. We'll take this as dS1 will be equal to A into t minus 0.05 t squared into dt. Now when we integrate, we have our limits from 0 to 15. So we'll use that. So integration of this will be from 0 to 15. We integrate on both the sides. So this one gives us S1 will be equal to, when we integrate it, S1 will be equal to A into t squared over 2 minus 0.05 into t cube over 3. The limits are from 0 to 15. In our question, it is given S1 equal to 225 meters. So instead of S1, we can write it as 225 will be equal to A into, just replace the values over here. So 15 square over 2 minus 0.05 into 15 cube over 3. And this when we substitute, it is a 0. So it will be 225 will be equal to A into 112.5 minus 56.25 minus 0. So 225 will be equal to A into 56.25, so which gives us A as 4. So now this A can be replaced by a 4. Therefore, now our V becomes, instead of A, we'll replace 4, T minus 0.05 T squared. At T equal to 15, V will be equal to 4 into 15 minus 0.05 into 15 squared. So when we simplify this, this is 15 meter per. Now substituting T equal to 15 and V equal to 15 in V equal to B over T squared. This equation is at this at 15, both the equations were satisfied. So we can substitute and get the value for B. So it will be 15 will be equal to B over 15 squared. So which implies B will be equal to 3375. Now in the second part, V equal to B over T squared. This is the equation given for T greater than or equal to 15. Let S2 be the distance for T greater than or equal to 15. So this V can be replaced by DS2 over DT will be equal to, our value for B is 3375 over T squared. Now again, we'll integrate it and then we'll try to find out our required distance. Simplified, we get it as ds2 equal to 3375 into t to the power of minus 2 into dt. Here we are not applying the limits for this integration because here the value for t is greater than or equal to 0. It is not a fixed limit. So now when we integrate it, this is s2 minus 3375 over 2 t to the power of minus 2 plus 1 or minus 2 plus 1. So we get it like this and a plus k. Now when t equal to 15, s2 will be equal to 225 substituting. Therefore 225 will be equal to minus 3375 over 15 plus k. When we simplify this, we get a value for k as 450. So our S2 will be equal to minus 3375 over T plus 450. This is the distance traveled when T is greater than or equal to 15. So S2 equal to minus 3375 over T plus 450 is the distance traveled when T is greater than or equal to 15. Now for the third part, given the total distance is 315, therefore, 315 will be equal to minus 3375 over t plus 450. So when we simplify, we get a value for t as 25 seconds. Now using v equal to b over t squared, speed of the vehicle. Will be equal to 3375 over 25 square, which is equal to 5.4 meter per second. Thank you.